mistake from the world champion. I can't believe my eyes. Fabio Quartararo, with the rarest of mistakes, has crashed here. That's game over for his victory hopes here in Holland.
And for Aleix Espargaró, he's now down in 15th.
And I wanted to overtake Aleix super fast, super earlier. That's why we crashed, you know?
When Fabio hit me, I was very angry because I knew that the victory was possible. And I said to myself, it was not your fault. So every single point that you are able to achieve right now will be like a present, will be free. And this is what I did.
That's more positions and places gained than for Aleix Espargaró.
To have the feeling to overtake that easy, the best riders of the world, I never had before.
Tirando como un asesino.
Peccato che non stiamo sul podio, cazzo. Incredibile, tio, incredibile. Nunca visto questo. Incredibile, tio. Incredibile.
No pasa nada. Es que no pasa nada. Y aparte es que si te hubiera visto, hubiera levantado, pero yo he cerrado la línea y no te he visto.
Estás bien.
Yo si te hubiera visto, hubiera levantado, pero es que te juro que no te he ni visto, tío.
No tiene nada que
ver. Dígale que no pasa nada, Max. Dile una abrazada. Dígale, para la próxima ya coñaré, ¿vale?
Chao. Chao. Chao.
From that moment, he started to believe that I was faster than what he expected. He hit me and he destroyed my race. So he had somehow to pay it. I think to pay it with a long lap penalty is good.
The penalty, I still think, is a joke. For me, it was the moment to say, okay, you can also make mistakes really easily. So be focused and try to don't commit again this mistake.
Fabio Quartararo is world champion! Their first ever win is pure delivery for a brilliant Pecco Bagnaia. What a race that was.
Thank you very much.
I arrived in Silverstone after the Assen race with really high expectations.
Oh, dearie me, I think that's Aleix Espargaró. It is indeed. That's been a massive crash for Aleix Espargaró. This is going to be really concerning for the man who's second in the MotoGP World Championship this year.
It's normal to have some crashes, but my one was quite high.
Aleix is one of the with the most strong attitude of everyone.
Sai che questo qui Aleix farà fatica, ha preso una botta, poverino, non farà fatica.
A horrible high-speed high side then for the man second in the World Championship, Aleix Espargaró. Without any question, it's going to be a bruising 20-lap race.
Fa fatica a muoversi,
sì, adesso. Sì, quelle curve lì, non c'è
fatica. Aleix Espargaró won the toughest 20 laps of his Grand Prix career. He salvages an epic ninth place.
Nosotros aquí era pole y ganar.
Sí, porque aquí recuperábamos.
No, no, aquí. Aquí recuperábamos, pero la mitad.
I really lose a good opportunity to win in Silverstone, so this affect me a little bit.
Esto es una que va muy rápido. Yo.
¿Ves? Piensa que comparado con él...
Estos iban parados, en comparado mismo. Conmigo.
I think I learned from my mistakes of the start of the season. I'm just trying to be more smart, I think.
A Dutch TT winner in 2022 is Pecco Bagnaia.
When I won and Fabio did zero with the crash, it helped me to have a great motivation.
At Silverstone in 2022. He takes a famous win here.
Ducati at the second part of the season, qualifying race, they were always there.
For Ducati in the top five.
Lo difícil que pasaron.
I think the true thing is that it's okay, the bike is fast, but all the Ducati riders are
too fast.
Too fast. Too fast.
Para mí es más que positivo que llegue Pepe.
Cuanto
más mejor, porque Pepo no quiere hacer
segundo,
Pepo no quiere ganar. Y a Fabio, al líder, que es el que tiene algo que perder. Claro, pero...
Chao,
Pepo, ¿qué tal?
¿Bien?
¿Estás contento? Fabio está diciendo que está preocupado, ¿eh?
¿Quién?
Fabio dice que está preocupado.
¿Por qué?
Porque vienes muy fuerte y es imposible pararte.
Ahora dices eso.
Pero es verdad.
Me gustaría ver una buena lucha con él a personales.
I was feeling that I was the strongest.
Look at how many people are here.
Yeah.
Imagine how much.
There's a few campers. Look over that side. All the way.
It's incredible, huh? Have to be over.
The Austrian Grand Prix here in MotoGP went underway. Andrea Bastianini got away well from pole position. So did Pecco Bagnaia in the middle of that front row. Bagnaia will swing straight into the lead. The dream launch then from the man who's going for three straight wins here in 2022. Pecco
Jacko Bagnaia wins at the Red Bull Ring in Spielberg.
What he did to turn the mood and start to win races without making any mistake was really difficult to do.
Piano, 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 piano. Surely they will take the victory here in Misano. Here comes Bastianini! Bastianini! Oh, how close was that?
Normally he pushed like a bastard, but today was not pushing just a bastard, was a bastard.
You start feeling that you are unbeatable.
Sei tranquillo, c'è anche questo giocatore.
Tranquillo no?
Non direi preoccupato, ma sì che veramente Pecco sta andando molto forte.
Bagnaia, a fourth straight victory for him.
He's the man to beat right now. He recovered a lot of points to us.
Nobody expect, you know, to see him winning race by race.
Siete stati bravi oggi.
Andiamo avanti. Andiamo avanti. Vedi, si alza continuando a vincere. Continui a guidare così.
When you see your rival winning all the races, or be every time competitive in the front, already in the qualifying, so can change something on your head.
Quarta.
Quarta in my information, still soft medium.
Qué raro, soft y medio. Va al revés que todos. Es el único que lleva esto.
Here comes Jorge Martin, use the power that Ducati blitzes by Fabio Quartararo down the hangar straight.
Pensábamos que la media iba a ser bien, pero cuando estaba detrás de cuatro pilotos, la maleta se ha calentado muchísimo y no teníamos más rueda, básicamente.
That I really realized that we were in a bad situation, I would say, was Misano. I was doing a really great pace. I was super fast. I did a good race, and we finished P5 quite far from them. When I go into the box, I say, I have not a problem. I just gave my 100%, and I don't know where we can improve. And this is the moment where I really realize they make a big step forward, and we stay in the same position.
Ho sentito che stavo al limite tutta la gara, ma stiamo lontano, abbiamo visto dove è il problema, che è quello di solito, ma è stato una giornata.
Di solito cosa fa? Ricordiamo.
La potenza.
I was obliged to put myself really on the limit.
I had the knife on the here, you know, so
I could not really enjoy. That was a little bit the situation during the second part of the season.
Conchi, hay suficiente emoción. ¿Ya? No, no, no. No, no, no confundamos conceptos. Vengo a recuperarme.
Por cierto, Marc Márquez, buena noticia, ¿no?
Sí, a ver si, si se puede intercalar también entre las Ducatis.
He will push himself to the maximum. We know Marc after the injury, also in a qualifying, lot of time take a toll, so he can maybe put nervous someone. But in Aragon, it didn't go that that well.
Absolutely magic start by Marc Márquez.
Fabio Quartararo has been collected mid-pack.
He ran into the back of Márquez, I think.
Oh, Fabio Quartararo, that's an absolute nightmare. It was an aggressive start by Marc Márquez. Fabio Quartararo caught up in some mid-pack mayhem.
To be champion, you need to have some luck. There, Fabio was unlucky because it was not full his mistake. Was a small mistake from another rider, that in that case was me, and he was planning to overtook me in the next corner, and bam.
It was also a moment where we lose a lot of points.
Over the line they come. Is it going to be Bastianini or Bagnaia? It's the beast that wins a classic on the last lap again.
Sometimes I was with a lot of pressure from other riders of Ducati, and it wasn't easy. I was angry to don't have the fifth win in a row.
We were able in the first part of the championship to fight for the podium every race. And at the second part of the season was completely the opposite.
You can understand why Alexis Espargaró is taking big risks, pushing that brilliant to the absolute limit. He takes the checker flag in sixth place.
Tenemos un problema con el motor, no funciona, no va el motor, no va. Que no puedo ni conducir. Si vamos, si el inicio de carrera iba parado. He ido al mapa 2, al mapa 3. Quitado el engine brake. No puede ser, tío. Binder con nosotros. Rodaba en 35 el viernes.
Vamos, Alex. Hay algo que no funciona en la moto,
Però, tio, ens està als aquests grans premis últims?
A mi m'ha costat molt.
Amb la soft, oi?
Amb fred i tal, amb la medium davant, vaig fatal.
I jo fatal. Què t'ha passat a la FP4? Has fet una FP4 com raro, no?
Ah, però és un problema.
No, ell talla ara una mica.
Has tallat o no?
No, no he tallat.
Vale. Both riders in Aprilia, we were having a lot of problems, a lot of, you know, lack of performance. And when you are fighting with somebody as Pecco, Fabio, it's, you know, it's difficult because you lose a lot of points.
No puedo detrás de ellos.
Es normal.
Es que Fabio me saca dos
décimas. Me dan una paliza de locos, no sé qué hacer.
Toda la violencia, ¿cómo la he visto?
He visto muy bien Fabio.
Aleix è un po' più in difficoltà, secondo me, un po' più lento.
Che hacemos mal? Che è lo che hacemos mal? È un mal sogno. Cuidado.
Vecina.
Se rompe la moto va bene, ma se rompe la cafettiera abbiamo un problema grave.
The flyaways are back and we're in the far east for the Motul Grand Prix of Japan. Fabio Quartararo, Pecco Bagnaia and Aleix Espargaró split by just 17 points with 5 races remaining. Oh, Aleix Espargaró, what is happening here? We've lost the man third at the end of the warm-up lap. The biggest loser in that top three right now clearly will be Aleix Espargaró. What drama here in Motegi. We lost Aleix Espargaró on the warm-up lap. A technical bump for the factory in Aprilia.
So let's see how it
Internally we discuss a solution for the future. We don't have it anymore, but then it's no meaning to have regret or to be upset. It's that.
Could we compose this mistake with the one you did in Romero in blue?
Aleix Espargaró's got a problem. Can you believe this? On the last lap, Aleix Espargaró is withdrawing from this Barcelona Grand Prix. On the last lap, he got his hand up. We just saw there Jorge Martin came throwing him down the main straight.
Once he got his thumb up?
Does he think the race is finished? I think he thinks it's realized. Over. Oh my goodness, can you believe it? What a howl by Aleix Espargaró. Good afternoon then and welcome back to the OR Grand Prix of Thailand. World champion Fabio Quartararo is fired up for another Ducati duel starting from fourth.
I had to touch. I made a bad start, bad first lap.
Disastrous first lap here. Quartararo started fourth. He came through sector two, 17th.
And then, of course, we made a mistake with the tire pressure.
Fabio Quartararo, the reigning world champion, a shocking 17th place.
Would you say that Thailand maybe was the worst moment of the season?
Yes, by far. I was really angry in the moment and I wanted to don't talk because I didn't want to say something bad of the team.
When it started to rain, I was not mad.
I think I recovered more points like this than
if it was dry, for sure.
How close to her?
Now it's 2 points.
2 points behind.
8 degree cold wind into the
pylon.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's amazing how quickly it can turn.
I wasn't anyone.
I know.
Psychological advantage on Fabio?
I think that in this moment we are in a better situation. We are very competitive, we are so strong.
What you should do if you have only 2 points? You have to go and you have to give your best. So at the end, you have more to lose, but you have a lot to gain, so you need to push yourself to the maximum.
Caduto Fabio, è caduto Fabio, bisogna darglielo questo.
Glielo diamo solo in tabella.
Ma Massimo, devi mettere Fabio out, Quartararo out, quello che hai. Quartararo out, va bene.
Bagnaia does, though, take over the lead at the MotoGP World Championship.
Ma sinceramente, quando ho visto Quartararo out, ho detto io mi metto primo. Se vinco bene, se no va bene anche il podio.
You're right.
So bad.
Fabio!
No está lejos, ¿eh?
No. A darle duro.
¿Te lo digo yo?
Sí.
Ok.
Okay.
14 points behind him, as you say, two races to go. Is today the day where the championship really changed?
Yeah, it changed for him since Saxon Ring, so it can change also for us.
The feeling that I have, and I think also in Aprilia, they have the same feeling, is that we were not able to maintain our rivals' level. That's for sure. That's a fact. I mean, and it's a shame because it was in our hands.
It has not been an end of a season to remember for the Nuali factory. Discount him from the title equation.
Dramático.
¿Estás triste?
Muy triste. La verdad es que sí, porque es. Yo no soy tonto, o sea, soy consciente de que era muy difícil ganar el Mundial, pero me hubiera gustado lucharlo hasta el final con los resultados que hemos estado haciendo la primera mitad de año y hemos hecho el ridículo estas últimas carreras. Se nos ha quedado grande. Se nos ha quedado grande.
Gracias, igualmente.
De aquí, ¿quién ha sido nuestro claro favorito para el título? Quedan dos. ¿Qué tienes que apostar?
Muy difícil, o la velocidad que ha conseguido Pecco y la estabilidad y la moto que ha conseguido Ducati se merecen este título, pero lo que está haciendo Fabio con la moto que tiene me parece impresionante. Para mí, si tuviera que escoger un piloto este año, el que mejor ha conducido es Fabio, pero no significa que se merezca más el título que Pecco, así que gane el mejor, aquí puede pasar de todo.